First of all, very warm greetings to all dear students. You all are really doing very, very well. Today I'm trying my best to make you understand about Hopsack wave, that is also called mat wave. This is the best possible way I could explain you. So forgive me for not using point paper. You need to practice all these things on point paper only. The main thing about Hopsack wave is basically there are two types of Hopsack wave, regular and irregular. Regular is, for example, 4 cross 4, 6 cross 6, 3 cross 3, right? Both the digits are of same number, then it is regular Hopsack wave. In case of irregular Hopsack wave, it may be 3 by 2, 2 by 4, 5 by 6, like that. So two digits are of different numbers. So that is irregular Hopsack wave. These two are the types of Hopsack wave. Now in case of regular Hopsack wave, if for example I want to draw 4 by 4 regular type of Hopsack wave, then one repeat would take size of 8 by 8, that is 4 plus 4. Then one repeat unit will need total 8 number of ends and 8 number of pics, that I will be explaining you in detail. Similarly, for 6 by 6 regular Hopsack wave, you need 12 by 12 repeat unit size, and for 3 by 3 you need 6 by 6 repeat unit size. The same way it goes for irregular Hopsack wave also. For example, in 3 by 2 irregular Hopsack wave, for one repeat unit you need 3 plus 2, that is 5. 5 number of ends and 5 number of pics, that is E by P, for one repeat unit would be 5 by 5. Same way for 2 by 4 it will be 6 by 6 repeat unit size, and for 5 by 6 it will be 11 by 11 repeat unit size. Both of these will be explained using one example step by step over here. Now starting for 4 by 4 regular Hopsack wave, as I said, for one repeat unit it will need total 8 number of ends and 8 number of pics. First of all, you need to draw block for one repeat unit, and you have to name it properly on point paper. Again, I am repeating, I don't have point paper, so I have drawn it on normal paper. You have to practice it on point paper. So like this you will be drawing for 8 by 8 repeat unit, that is end 1 to end 8 and pick 1 to pick 8. When you will complete your wave, you will see it is divided into 4 equal parts, that is A, B, C and D. How? We will see. Once you have drawn for 8 ends and 8 picks, you have to go to your starting point, that is E1 cross P1, which is shown over here. E1, P1, this is your starting point. And from this, you have to mark cross up to 4 picks, 1, 2, 3, 4, because it is 4 by 4 regular Hopsack wave. So you have to draw 4 cross marks up to pick number 4, and the same process you have to repeat up to end number 4, that is up to this point, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Once you finish, this portion is over, that is portion A. Now you have to repeat the same process for the next block, that is your next starting point. Your next starting point would be for end number 5, and that will be your E5 cross P5, that is this point. From this starting point, you have to repeat the same procedure, that is draw 4 cross marks, 1, 2, 3 and 4, because it is 4 by 4 regular Hopsack wave. And this process you have to do up to end number 8, that is you will finish doing this block. So if you will draw like this, it will complete 4x4 Hopsack view, which is regular Hopsack view. And you can see this is divided into 4 equal parts, 1, 2, 3 and 4. I'll name it A, B, C and D. As you can see, A and C are fully covered by upward markings and B and D are completely blank. This is how you draw any regular Hopsack view. Now let us switch over to irregular Hopsack view. I have taken this example of 3x2 irregular Hopsack view. For drawing one repeat unit, you have to have 3 plus 2, that is 5, 5x5 ends and pics, that will give you one repeat unit. Once you will finish this, you will come to know, unlike regular Hopsack view, you will see there are uneven cells created here, A, B, C and D, but it will be of uneven size because it is irregular Hopsack view. Now we will go to the point paper and we will start drawing one repeat unit, that is 5x5. I have drawn over here 5x5, total 5 ends and 5 picks. Same way, just like we did in regular Hopsack view, the only difference is here you have 3x2. That means for first step you have to go to your first starting point, that is E1 cross P1, and you have to start from this point up to 3 picks, that is 1, 2 and 3, up to this point. And you have to repeat these up to end number 3. That means this cell is complete. Now you have to go to your next starting point, that is E4 cross P4. Because this is irregular, the next digit is 2. That is why you have to do it for 2 picks, 1 and 2. Your starting point is E4 cross P4. And 2 times you have to repeat, that is 1 and 2. And the same thing you have to do on next end also, that is end number 5. Once you will finish this, your 3x2 Hopsack view is completed. Here you can see A, B, C and D. Here also A and C are filled, B and D are blank. These cells creates Hopsack view. The difference is here it is in regular pattern, here it is in irregular pattern. So this is regular Hopsack view and this is irregular Hopsack view. One more query was about this same stitching point. It is very very simple. Once you know the Hopsack view, the only thing changed over here is the corner point markings in cell A and C are changed, and in cell B and D it is replaced. Just like I have shown here, this is regular Hopsack view. If you will switch over the stitching points of these corners 1, 2, 3 and 4 to the next cell, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Similarly, from these 4 corners 1, 2, 3, 4 to this corner, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. These will also create cell-like structure, but the stitching points are changed, and that is why the name of this view is different, and that is Mockleno view, which we are going to study next. But because you had some query regarding this, so I clarified over here. I tried my level best to make you understand in the most simpler way. You all are doing very, very well. Keep it up. Well done.